Only on 7 News. It sounds like a good deal. Lease a new car, get a tax break. Well, not so fast.
All 7 investigator John Ferrugia is here, and you found out that this sales pitch for hybrid cars has left some people with some pretty big tax bills.
That's right, Mike. Our investigation has found the State Revenue Department has notified nearly 200 Colorado taxpayers they improperly took more than $300,000 in hybrid vehicle tax credits, credits that actually belong to the company owning the vehicle.
Now, I've also heard that they also have, tax rebates for those.
They do.
Do they give it to you if you're leasing?
Yes.
When we went asking about tax credits for leasing a new Prius, at this dealership, we were assured the customer would get the tax deal.
Because I looked on there and they said something about, you know, either the lessee or the leasor gets that.
Yeah, you would get that. We don't take it.
You don't take it?
And how much were you going to get?
I was going to get over $2,000.
In a tax credit?
In a tax credit.
Jillian Buck and other Colorado consumers got the same pitch, and she took the deal because that $2,000 would take care of several payments, and all she had to do was claim the tax credit on her Colorado return.
I got the money. It was great.
Yeah.
And then I got a letter saying they wanted it back, that I was not actually eligible for the rebate that I'd already returned because Toyota maintains the ownership of that car throughout the lease, and they submit for the refund.
In fact, despite what this Boulder dealership told Jillian, on a lease, Toyota keeps the tax credit.
I was feeling duped. I was feeling taken advantage of. I was feeling angry. I had a hard time getting anyone on the phone to even directly give me an answer.
And she wasn't the only one.
We noticed this become rising up in the last year or so.
Mark Couch with the Colorado Department of Revenue says many Coloradans are now being asked to return that tax credit.
Folks are getting some letters saying somebody else has already claimed this credit, and that would be the owner of the vehicle.
And the owner of the leased vehicle in Jillian's case is Toyota. And after months of complaining, Jillian says the dealer, who declined an on-camera interview, gave her $700 in compensation. When we recently checked with our hidden camera, the sales pitch here had clearly changed.
I heard that they have some sort of a federal or state tax credit, or
not if you lease.
Not if you lease. Okay.
Because Toyota owns the vehicle.
But at this Lakewood dealership, the salesman continued to insist that the customer would get the tax credit.
You would take that on your tax return.
Okay. Any idea how much that is?
You know, we're car salesmen, we don't give tax advice.
Right. No, I understand that.
You understand that. So you're probably looking at $1,500 or something like that.
That's not bad. That's half a year's lease payment, so.
Yeah. Right. You know. Yeah. And that comes right back on your tax return.
And so the people who lease from here get it all the time.
Oh, yeah.
He was inaccurate.
Kent Stevenson is owner of the Lakewood store and six other area dealerships. The company has been in business for 50 years.
We did a poor job in training, clear and simple. And since you contacted us, we've put in some opportunities to clarify and retrain with what's going on.
Stevenson says there's no advantage in making a mistake and giving customers the wrong information. And clearly, it's a mistake many dealerships have made.
Our side should be more schooled, more trained, and say, and also know their own limits. If you came to me and said, Kent, do you know? And I said, you know what, I'm really not up to date on that. I'll get to someone who does.
And he says customers should also do their homework before committing to a deal. That's advice Jillian understands.
I'm definitely going back in with a new light of not taking anybody's word for anything next time I do that.
And that's good advice, because we went to other dealerships where one salesman would tell us we were entitled to that credit on the lease, and then the supervisor would come back later and say we weren't. We found out late today that two legislators concerned that consumers were misled will introduce a bill tomorrow that would let consumers keep that tax credit for now and not pay the penalties assessed by the Department of Revenue. It's unclear whether that's going to have enough support to pass. But the takeaway here, obviously, is if you don't want one of those letters telling you to give the money back, then you better be informed before you walk in the door.
Takeaway being the operative word here.
Absolutely, because you're going to be stuck with that car.
Exactly. All right. Thanks a lot, John. Now, if you have a new tip for John or any of our Call 7 investigators, give them a call at 303-832-7777 or contact us through email, Facebook, or Twitter.